अस्सलाम वालेकुम, आई उमर फारूक, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स ऑफ केएमई सोसाइटी जीएम वुमेन विमेंस कॉलेज, वेलकम यू टू द फर्स्ट लेक्चर ऑफ सेकेंड ईयर बीएससी इन द सब्जेक्ट मैथमेटिक्स पेपर वन. एंड इन दिस सब्जेक्ट टुडे विल स्टडी द फर्स्ट पार्ट, फर्स्ट चैप्टर विच इज named as functions of several variables. First thing, let us quickly revise definition of function. What is a function? Let A and B be non-empty sets. A function f from A to B is a rule which assigns each element of A a unique element of B. So every element of A should be given some value, and that should be a unique value of a unique element of B, then it is known as a function. If some element of A remains unassigned, which is not assigned any value of B, then it will not be a function, it will be just a relation. Similarly, if an element of A has been assigned more than one element from the set B, then again it will not be a function, it will be only a relation. So if f from A to B is a function, then A is called as domain and B, the set B, is called as codomain. All these things are known already to you. Some examples of functions that we already know are f from R to R, real valued function defined by f of x is equal to x square. Similarly, f of x is equal to log of x, f of x is equal to x, f of x is equal to sine of x, f of x is equal to e raised to x. All these are the functions that we already have studied in first year and in the classes before that. And in fact, we have studied different properties of functions also, like limit, continuity and derivatives of those functions. Okay. In these examples, we can see easily that all the functions are functions of only one variable x. So these are only functions of one variable. And these are real valued functions because all these functions have real codomain as R, set of real numbers. Now we'll come to the definitions of functions of several variables. Okay. So if we have f, which is a function from Rn to Rm, where Rn means maybe R2 to R3, maybe R2 to R2, maybe R3 to R2. So, a function like this, f from Rn to Rn, is said to be a function of several variables if n is greater than 1. If this n is greater than 1, if this is equal to 1, then it will be again the same, means f will be from R to some Rn. So, the domain will have only one variable, in that case it will be function of one variable. If this n is more than 1, then it will be function of several variables. For example, 1, f from R2 to R is defined as fxy is equal to x into y. In this function, we have R2 as domain. So, every element of R2 is an ordered pair, x, y. Okay. So, the function is defined on ordered pair. So, it is fxy, a function defined on xy is fxy. Here, it is x into y. When I am talking about ordered pair x, y, each component is a real number. So, x is a real number and y is a real number. So, the product x into y is a real number. This is not a vector. This is a real number. So, this belongs to R. This is a real number. But, the ordered pair x, y is in R2. Therefore, this is a function whose value is R. So, it is a real valued function. But, it is defined on order pair which has two variables. So this is a function of two variables. Similarly, fxy is equal to square root of x square plus y square is again a function of two variables. So this R2 will decide, this is the dimension of R in the domain will decide whether this is a function of two variables or more than two variables. Let us consider another example of this function of several variables. F from R2 to R2 is fxy is equal to xy comma x plus y. This function has, it is defined on the order pair x comma y, and its image is in again R2. So this is an order pair x into y comma x plus y. So its x coordinate is x into y. The first coordinate, first element is x into y. The other second element is x plus y. This is a real number and this is also a real number. In vector form, we are many times writing this as, we can write this as x into y into I cap plus x plus y into j cap. Okay, so this looks like a vector. So the same vector in component form can be written as x into y comma x plus y. So this is a vector quantity. So it is a vector function, but it is defined on R2. So it is a vector function of two variables x and y. Similarly, f of x y is equal to x minus y comma x plus y upon x square plus y square is another function of several variables of two variables. Okay, this can be written in vector form like x minus y into I cap plus x plus y upon x square plus y square into j cap. Third example I want to take over here is f from R3 to R as fx y z is equal to sine of x square plus y square plus z square. Here domain is R3. In R3, in three dimension, we have three coordinates x, y and z. So we have here three variables x, y and z. So f defined on order triplet x comma y comma z is here defined as sine of x square plus y square plus z square. So this is a function of three variables x, y and z. Although its value is sine of x square plus y square plus z square, this is a real number. We'll see this that this is a real valued function. On the similar lines, one more function r from r cubed to r is defined as r of x, y, z is equal to square root of x square plus y square plus z square. This is actually known as the modulus of the position vector. Okay, this is also a function of three variables x, y and z. So these are three definitions, examples of functions of several variables. Now let us come to a definition of a scalar valued function and vector valued functions. So what is a scalar valued function? F from Rn to R, when we have a function f which is defined from Rn, but its codomain is R, R raised to 1, means it is of dimension 1 only, set of real numbers. This is known as scalar valued function when R codomain is R only. Okay. For example, distance between any two points or temperature at any time, these are definitions, these are examples of some scalar quantities, or you can say the scalar functions. Then we see definition of vector valued function. If we have function f from Rn to Rm, where this m is greater than 1, this is not R, this is R, this may be R2, may be R3, may be R4 or any higher dimension, then this is a vector valued function. Okay, if m is greater than 1. For example, if you see the quantities, then velocity, acceleration and position vector, these are some examples of vector quantities which can be considered as vector valued functions. We'll see these in details. Then come to the length or norm of a vector. Length is actually norm. So if x is equal to here an n tuple in Rn, x1, x2, x3 up to xn be any vector, then its length, which is denoted by norm of f, this is the notation for norm of x, two parallel lines, vertical lines, and in between that x is written. This is norm of x is defined as norm of x is equal to square root of x1 square plus x2 square plus dot 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 plus xn square. This actually has been obtained by taking square root of x dot x, which is the dot product of vector with itself. So this square root of dot product of a vector with itself gives us norm of a function of a vector, that means length of a vector. Let us have one more definition which will be useful in our chapter. distance in Rn. If we have any two vectors x and y in Rn, n-tuples, vectors means n-tuples in Rn, then the distance between these two vectors is denoted by distance between x and y is denoted by norm of x minus y. X minus y is the vector which is obtained by taking difference of x and y. This is a vector, its norm, its length will be distance between x and y. And we can see, if we use this formula, we see that x minus y will be the vector x1 minus y1 comma x2 minus y2 comma x3 minus y3. It will be a vector, and using this definition of norm, this distance will become this, which is known as the distance formula. Okay, square root of x1 minus y1 square plus x2 minus y2 square plus up to xn minus yn square. So these are certain terms that we need to remember while studying the functions of several variables and the properties of functions of several variables. As we have defined properties of norm, we must know some properties of norm, as non-negativity. Norm, as we have defined, is positive square root of something, so it is never negative. Okay, norm of x is greater than or equal to 0. Then norm of x is 0 if and only if x is 0. Okay. Third property is norm of lambda times x is equal to mod of lambda into norm of x when lambda is any scalar number. So when we take this scalar number out of norm, it becomes mod of lambda. Okay. For example, norm of 2x will be 2 times norm of x. But norm of minus of x will be mod of minus 1 into norm of x. So that mod of minus 1 will become 1. Similarly, norm of minus 2x will be equal to mod of minus 2 into norm of x. In that case, mod of minus 2 will again become 2x. So it shows that this is never negative. Okay. And the third property is known as triangular inequality, is that norm of x plus y is always less than or equal to norm of x plus norm of y for all x and y in Rn. Thank you.